guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, oh, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother, howdy, when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother, hey, when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I walk, oh, that milky white way. Some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father, God the Son. Well, 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 I want to tell them all about my trouble.
Destruction and say return ye children of men. give in thy sight. But as of yesterday, when it is past, it has a watch in the night. Thou carried them away as with the flood. They are as asleep. In the morning, they are light. Grass which grows up. In the morning, it's burned. It is cut down and withered. We are consumed by thy anger and by thy wrath. We are troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all of our days are passed away as in the wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. He said the days of our years are 80 years, and then if by reason of strength they be fourscore years. Yet is their strength, labor, and sorrow. For they soon cut down, and we fly away. Who know the power of thy anger, even according to thy fear? So is thy wrath. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long? Let it repent thee concerning thy servant. Safely that you satisfy us early with thy mercy, that we may rejoice and be glad all of our days. Make us glad according to the days wherein thou hast afflicted us, in the years wherein we have sinned. Let thy work appear to thy servant, and the glory unto the church. Let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us, and establish thou the works of thy hands unto us, the work of our hands, and ye yet establish. He said in Psalms 91, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge. In him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snares of the fire, the noose and the pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feather, and under his wing shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and thy buckler. said that a thousand shall fall at thy side and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come near to thee. Only in thy eyes shall thou behold and see the reward, because thou hast made the law, which is my refuge. Even the Most High, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come near thee that dwell in thee. For I heard him say that he shall give his angel charge over thee, lest thou foot of his disciple. Because he had set his love on me, therefore will I deliver him, I will set him on me, because he had known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. It's a good thing to give thanks to you, Lord, because thou hast made me glad through thy works. Oh Lord, how great are thy works. Lord, are thou most high forever. The righteous, those that be planted in the house of the Lord, shall flourish in the courts of God. So the Lord is upright. He is my rock, and there's no unrighteousness in him. David said that the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will feel no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. David said, thou prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointed my head with oil, my cup runneth over. But David said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Brothers and sisters, we give honor to God Almighty, who is the head of all of our lives. To the Holy Ghost, our Comforter, our Keeper, and our Guide, we give honor. To all the fellow sufferers of the gospel, we give honor to this bereaved family. We're here in the home going of our beloved brother, Mr. to Loroderick K. Doster. The family have an order of service that has been prepared for them and by them, and we want to stick as close as possible to them. We know now that we have prayer comfort, Reverend Isaac Owen, Old Testament scripture, Reverend Isaac Owen, New Testament, Reverend Peter Lester. A solo will be done by Reverend Nelson Maynard. Reflection, anyone desire, but they put limit 2 minutes each, please. And then we have Mr. Griggs will come with a solo. Then we will proceed with the eulogy at this time.
Pray. Eternal God, our Father, we come to you now with our heads bowed and our hearts filled. Oh Lord, but we come to you realizing and knowing that even now you are able to give this family the strength that they need. And oh God, as we come to you now, we pray that you would look down upon them and that you would see them just where they are. Oh God, we pray that you would strengthen this mother, this family as a whole. Allow them to know that even now you are still God. You're still able, and you're still able to take care of them. God, as we come, we realize and we know that tears may fall from our eyes, and we know that our hearts overflowing, but we know that you are a God who is able to wipe every tear away. And oh God, as we lift this family up to you, we pray right now that you would hold them together, that you would keep them strong in this hour, realizing and knowing that this is all a part of your will. And oh God, even when we don't understand, we pray now that you would help us to understand your will and your way. God, as we come to celebrate Pop, we thank you, oh God, for allowing him to walk amongst us. Thankful, oh God, for him being the kind of son that he was, the kind of grandson, the kind of brother, the kind of friend that he was. God, we thank you for his way of living, oh God. Thank you, oh God, for his mannerisms. And oh God, even now we realize and we know that we will miss him. But we know we too one day must go this same way. Help us, oh God, now to begin making preparation for. We don't know when and we don't know where. But God, help us to be ready when our time comes. And then, oh God, in the days to come, as this family continues to mourn, we pray that when everybody else has gone home, that you'll still be right there with them. That you'll be right there rocking them and holding them and letting them know that even though they can't see it now, that the sun will shine again. For God, we know that you are the sun, and that because of you, we are able to look, allow them to look to the hills for whence cometh their help, knowing and realize that all of our help coming from thee and thee alone. God, we thank you, and we praise you for every blessing. We ask for all these blessings now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our Old Testament scripture comes from the book of Psalms. Psalms 27, one verse number 14. It says, wait on the Lord. Be of good cheer. Wait, I say, on the Lord. I pray that the family find comfort in the word of God, realizing and knowing now he is still able to take care of us at a time such as this.
Deepest sympathy to the family, the Doster family. May God have mercy on all of you. My scripture coming from St. John, chapter 11, 25 and 26. It says, Jesus said, I am the resurrection, the life. He believeth in me, though he was dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me, yet shall never die. Amen. Give unto God, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and to the Doster family. I want to let you know that you have my deepest sympathy as I've been where you are. Amen. I too have lost a child. And that's something you never get used to, parents burying their children, but you always expect the children to bury the parents. God knows best. Amen. So lift up your heads, all ye gates, so the King of Glory can come in. Just a little song I'd like to leave you with today. Go something like this. I'm going on a long journey after a while. Oh, thank you, Lord. Going on a long journey after a while. Oh yeah, I'm gonna lay my burden down, going home to get my crown. Going on a long, long, long journey after a while. Oh yes I am. Listen, God knows I have a good religion. Thank you, Jesus, I'm not ashamed. Say the Holy Ghost is my witness, and the angel done signed my name. I can look all around me and see, oh, how good the Lord been for me. Going on a long, long, long journey after a while. Oh, thank you, Lord. God knows I got a good religion. How about you? Thank you, Jesus, I'm not ashamed. Cause the Holy Ghost is my witness, and the angel done signed my name. Yes, I can look all around me and see, oh, how good the Lord been for me. Yes, I'm going on a journey after a while. Oh, thank you, Lord. Sometimes I like to be in company, then again I like to be all alone, so I can talk to my Heavenly Father up in heaven on the throne. Tears in my eyes, oh, keep working till I see him smile. Yes, I'm going on a journey after a while. Oh, thank you, Lord. Yes, I'm going on a journey after a while. Oh, thank you, Lord. I'm going on a journey. I am gone on a journey at the time. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, give it all some praise. Tell him go.
Thank you.
at this time, we have a reflection to anyone desiring this time.
Childish giggle. That was very good. My half-late wife showed all of us just know that she still got family in us, too. Because not only our work don't work, but it was our family. We love you.
Thank you.
So heaven,
God, help me.
To this bereaved family, we pray today that you find words of comfort for them. Let us bow our heads for a moment. Our wise everlasting and eternal God, our Father, we come now asking, Master, that you throw your long arms of protection around them and keeping each and every one of them. And then, Father God, as we come before your people with your word, we ask that you will not be lifted up. That may speak to somebody's heart. God, we pray now that you build us up where we've been torn down, strengthen us where we are. And Father, we're so careful to give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. In your son Jesus' name, amen. Amen. In Daniel Gospel, the third chapter, Daniel 3, amen, verse number 17. If it be so, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and will deliver us out of thy hand, O King. But if not, be it known unto thee, O King, that we will not serve thy God nor to worship the golden image that thou hast set up. I want to talk for just a few minutes today to the family. I want to talk about God is able. Amen. God is able. The text today that we look at today is focused on three Hebrew believers who acknowledge the permissive will of God, the power of God, and the acceptedness of his will. Now, Clark had a quiet demeanor about himself. He was an humble young man. And God knows if Clark could do anything for you, Clark will do it. Many times, not just Clark, but I got to put Mickey in there with him. Many times I needed some things done, I could just call Pop and me. And I'm going to be forever grateful. I know God is able today. But we see here the king down in Babylonian conquering all.
the region of Judea. And then they were carrying out some of the most crafted scholars, thinkers back in the Babylonian time. And he began a 3-year teaching program to these Jews so they would accept their custom. And among the four, commonly known as Daniel, come on somebody, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. Commonly known today, the four were believers in the kingdom of God Almighty. They prayed regularly, even refused the king's effort to re-educate themselves in a political viewpoint. But Daniel interpreted a dream for the king. And so Daniel was given the opportunity to serve as the prime minister or leader of the governors in that land. And it was a position that he refused. Amen, somebody. Amen. However, he recommended that, I'm not going to take the position, but I'm going to recommend Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I have three other peoples. Amen, somebody. Amen, that I would recommend. And I say today, I recommend that you get a quiet demeanor and a spirit like Pop had. Amen, somebody. Amen. Many times you seen Pop, if he was going to the store, wherever he was going, he had his do-rag on. Amen, somebody. Amen. And out of all that, he just was so humble, good-spirited. Amen, somebody. And I ain't saying he was perfect, because none of us, all of us, amen, we're not perfect, amen. But one thing about Pop, he kept his priorities in line. Amen, somebody. Amen. Pop was dedicated, amen, to his job. Didn't mind going to work. Amen. Didn't mind asking you to give him a ride to work before he got away to work. See, a lot of us let pride stand in the way. Come on, somebody. But Pop didn't let that stand in the way. When he needed some, amen, some help on something, he didn't mind asking. I want you to know today, family, God is able. That Daniel and his associates to the king was, amen, that who wanted to predict a happier future for the king and his rule. And now, when the music played, as expected, come on somebody, three of the nation's highest governmental officers refused to bow down. I want you to know the king said, well, I'm going to address them by asking them whether they understood the order, come on somebody, and the punishment for those who refused, amen, my order. And they, amen, they acknowledged that they understood, but they still refused to obey the king's order. Yeah, amen. So in frustration and retaliation, the king commanded punishment upon them. And when he saw that the three Hebrew believers would not bow, he asked them a question. Who is that God that shall deliver you out of my hand? I wish I had some help here today. Amen. Amen. In answer to, amen, the king, the Hebrew believer said, amen, that made their affirmation that God may permit it to be so. Come on, somebody. That we was able to be delivered. Amen. But listen to what they said. Amen. But if not, come on, somebody. Amen. I wish I had some if not people in heaven. Amen. The king ordered that the furnace be prepared. Amen. This time it should be passed 7 times hotter. Are y'all going to help me out today? Amen. Than any other time, any other day. And they were strung down in the furnace. But they, amen. But they could not burn up. And I want you to know, out of all our ups and downs, all of our going and coming, I want somebody to know that God is able today. Are y'all going to talk with me? Yeah. Amen. They said that there was no smell of smoke, no fire on their clothes as well. And the people waited for them to scream. Amen. Amen. You know, one thing about it, people wait for your downfall. They wait to see you go through something. But amen. But while they was waiting for one thing, God already had worked something else out. And I want you to know something the other day, other Saturday, amen, I want to say to Jen and the family, God already had worked something out. Are y'all going to help me out?
Yeah.
Amen. So listen to what it, God said, the Hebrew believers had received no reassurance that, amen, he would be delivered. But David, when he moved against Goliath, amen, said, this day will the Lord deliver thee into my hand. Joshua, Moses, and Elijah, all of them react with grace, faith, assurance. And I want you to know today that the Hebrew believers, are y'all going to help me out today? Say, if it be so, seeing to say, if it be so, well, amen, well, this difficult thing that's confronting me, if it be so, we're confident because we are supported in the word. Even if we have been promised, amen, a deliverance will come because we remember the word of the 121st Psalms and 3rd, amen. He will not suffer that foot to be moved. He that keepeth, he will not slumber. Verse 7, the Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. And I want you to know something today. The God we serve is able today. Come on, somebody. Amen, amen. The king wanted to know, who is the God of the Hebrew believers that they should think him more powerful than he could deliver them out of my hands? Are y'all going to talk with me?
All right, go ahead.
Amen. And there was an army guard and standing close by.
Yeah.
All the power of the government was at the king's disposal. Yeah. Amen. But the prospect of deliverance from the king's hand was non-existent. In other words, what the king said that it was going to be that way, They believed it, but I want you to know something. God said it's going to be another way.
That's right.
Are y'all going to talk with me?
Yeah.
Amen. I got confirmation from God that it's going to be another way. Are y'all going to talk with me?
Yeah.
Despite the impossible situation, the Hebrew believers confirmed that they believe that our God is able.
Yeah.
Amen. And like the believers, we too must remain confident in God's ability. Amen. That our God is able today. Are y'all gonna talk with me?
Right.
Now let's look at something. The Hebrews resolve that God is able. Even the power of the government, no match for God. Are y'all gonna help me out?
Yeah.
That's what King Ahab found out when the state control prophet of Baal was challenged at Mount Carmel.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Ahab learned that the state's 400 prophets could not stand against the simple prayers of one man backed up by God. Are y'all going to talk with me today?
Yeah.
Amen. I want you to know something today. Amen. That God is able today.
Yes.
Yeah. The Hebrews were confirmed in their faith.
Uh-huh.
They obeyed God. Are y'all going to talk with me?
Uh-huh.
They knew their relationship with him, and they knew the power of deliverance with him within his will.
Enjoyed my life. I've enjoyed the memories and the good times we shared together. And while you will miss me in the many things we did together, just know that you too one day must come the same way. And I look forward to the day when we'll be able to see each other, when we'll join hands, and together we'll say, we made it over, we made it over. But until that day, live, love, and enjoy. For no one knows the day, nor the hour. But just know that just as sure as time has come for me, the time will one day come for each of you. The family of Mr. Loroderick, Keontae, Doster wishes to express their most sincere and heartfelt appreciation to each of you who have been so kind to them. They thank you for all gestures of love and sympathy that have been extended to them. They thank you for the visits, phone calls, but most of all, they thank you for praying for them. They ask that you will continue to pray for them in the days to come as they grow stronger to know that we serve a God who is able, one who could do anything but fail. At this time, we wish to acknowledge four of the offerings that have been sent for the family. With deepest sympathy, the class of 1980. With deepest sympathy, Mr. and Mrs. Eddie Stubbs Jr. and family, Stockbridge, Georgia. The Lewis family, Faye, Jared, Deidre, and Carlos. With deepest sympathy, the Chris County High School class of 2003. With love and sympathy, the Searcy family. The family flowers giving their love and memory of a loving, caring son, brother, uncle, cousin, nephew, and friend from the family. In love and memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President, along with the staff of the J.W. Williams Funeral Home, is pleased to present to this family heirloom Bible. It is our prayer that you know that no matter what you're going through, that the answer is found in the Word of God. Allow His Word to be your source of strength and comfort in the days to come. We're also pleased to present to this family a picture or a trigger of your loved one's life. May you cherish all the many memories that you share together as a family, and may those memories forever live on in your heart. And finally, we present to this family this memorial keepsake blanket. We pray that you cherish all the memories that you share together, and may those memories forever live on in your heart. For we know that anyone who has ever loved is never lost. And because he was loved so much, he will forever live on in each of us who have the opportunity to know him. It is our prayer that you're blessed now and always.
This I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Not that the corruption inherit any corruption. I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but shall be changed in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye. At the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall change. For this corruption shall have put on incorruption, this mortal shall have put on immortality. Then it swallowed up, death is swallowed up the victory. Death, where is that stain? Oh, grave, where is that victory? Stain of death is sin. And strength the sins of the law, but thanks be to God. Give us the victory through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brother, be ye steadfast, unmoved, always abounding in the works of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in the money, in the Lord. For as much as it hath pleased Almighty God and his wild prophets to take out of this world and tend the soul of our deceased brother, we therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection, truth and the light of glory. Heard a voice from heaven say, right, blessed are the dead who died in the Lord. Let us pray.
We're here just for a moment. Now, God of peace, we're brought again from the dead, our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of everlasting covenant, make you perfect. Every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well pleasing in the Spirit through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever. Amen. Benediction. May the grace of God, the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost, rest upon the divine and keep that people henceforth, dying forever. Amen.